Welcome to the Fearless Center podcast. This is episode 42. Today is Monday, September 23rd, 2013. My name is Courtney, and you can also find me as Stitches Please on Ravelry, Plurk, and Instagram. Alrighty, this week was pretty uneventful. I didn't do anything. I was supposed to have labor class last weekend, but that got canceled. So Sunday, I barely even got out of bed. And my Saturday was really weird, sleep-wise, my sleep schedule. I'll get to that in my whips. My sleep schedule was off. Alright, first talk about knit-alongs that I'm hosting. We still have the 10K Knits knit-along going on. It's still going. From August 1st till September 30th, so you have one more week exactly, because next Monday is the 30th. I won't close the thread till, I'm not going to say midnight because I be asleep, probably the next morning or right before I go to sleep because that's pretty late. Eastern time. I can't think. And I will draw the prizes the following week, so October 7th. And the prizes will be, so I keep looking to the side because that kind of reminds me of what I'm talking about. The prizes are a giftable pattern, any pattern, for $10 or less. This pretty yarn, it's from Unique Sheep, the Unique Sheep. It's the Wildling Base, custom teal. It was dyed for me. And it's 50-50 merino and Tessa silk. 100 grams, 250 yards of a DK weight. So, there you go. And then the other prize came in the mail from my friend Pam, MZ Purple. She donated this cute bag, this drawstring bag, and yes, I'm hiding it well from Boogie because he will eat this ribbon. So, just a drawstring bag. And it'll come with stitch markers she made in her Etsy shop. It's Little Sweetheart Knits. I don't know if they sell stitch markers on it. It's her and another friend. I think they just sell knitted, hand knitted baby clothes. And then she also made this little case. It's intended for headphones, but honestly, you can put stitch markers and stuff in there too, I think. It is hummingbird. So that's all one prize. And do you want to say hello? Sit down now. I haven't seen her since I got home from work. She's been hiding. No, she's kicking me. Okay, go. I guess she didn't want to say hello. And now Boogie's coming over saying, why did you pick her up and not me? And then I have a thank you because with the prize, she also sent me a baby hat for my baby. It's a barley hat from Tin Can Knits. And it's really interesting because it has this garter section here and then stockinette here. And she added a little flower. You might have just heard Sedona hiss. So it's very cute. Yep, they're fighting now. I have no finished objects, but I have whips. The same exact whips that I had last week. How lame is that? I keep feeling like I look like I have a double chin. So I'm sorry. I'm like, oh my God. I think it's how I have the camera tilted myself in the shadow. I hope. Anyway, I digress. That's why recording while you look at yourself is not really a good idea. But yes, same old projects. First is the Tiddlywinks baby set by Nina Isaacson. You're probably so tired of hearing me talk about this. I'm knitting the 12-month-old size out of Knit Pig's comfy fingering in marlin, ivory, flamingo, and honeydew, and this is my last ball. I had a lot of yarn barf going on and other things, and my hair is, there we go. So I had to wind it by hand. And I'm still on the damn hood, but I've finished the increases. I'm just on the plain, excuse me, plain stockinette part now. And I'm almost at the decreases. So here's the stitch marker. I did all this. And it kind of now wants to do this part, so that's good. Here's the rest of the body. So cute. Yeah, she will definitely have to grow into this one. After this one, I'm gonna knit some more suit white cardigans, I tell you this much. And I actually just ordered yarn with my local yarn store for a DK weight cardigan. Somebody found me a pattern. We went through a bunch of magazines because somebody else had yarn picked out and they were trying to find a pattern. And my knitting group, I'm the youngest by like 20 years. So Ravelry and internet is like foreign. So they had the stacks and stacks of magazines and books, and she had this yarn picked out and she had an idea of what she wanted to knit. So we were going through there trying to help find her a pattern, and somebody found a baby pattern and I have to knit it. So I ordered the yarn for it. Anyways, that's a future project. Next, let's talk about my Saturday. My camera's tilted weird. I'm sorry if this is like the weirdest angle and I look like I have a double chin. I don't, I swear. Okay, Saturday. I went to bed on Friday night at 11, which is my usual going to bedtime. I woke up at 2 in the morning, wide awake. Like, wide awake. To the point, I got up and started watching podcasts and was knitting. My husband woke up like half an hour after I'd been up, and he came in here like, why is the light on? Because I went into the office across from our bedroom, and he first woke up and he thought that he had woken me up with snoring and that I went downstairs and slept on the couch. But then he noticed the light, and that's when he came in here like, what the hell? And I'm like, hey, how's it going? I'm wide awake. Woo-hoo. Let's do some knitting. So he laid back down. I told him, go to sleep. Well, like 5:30-ish, I kind of felt a little tired, so I laid down. I did not go back to sleep till like 6:30. Got back up at 8, wide awake. Went to my knitting store, hung out at my knitting store, and took a nap at 3 p.m. and got back up at 4 p.m. I don't know what the hell that was. I'm glad I was on a weekend though. I don't think I would have made it to work. But anyway, I knit on. Oh, the Tiddlywinks is on size US 2, 2.75 mm needles. But while I was awake at 2 in the morning watching podcasts, I knitted on Rocco the Rocking Robot by Jenna Krupar, who's also known as Retro Lemon from Retro Lemon Studios. And I believe she has a podcast too. And I'm knitting it out of Cascade 220 leftovers. So this is the daffodil colorway. And then here's the scrap. This is burgundy. And then I have some Venice Choice, I believe the color is called silver gray. And I'm knitting that on US 4, 3.5 mm needles. This is a big old honking robot. In the picture, he doesn't look that big, but he is going to be like in the picture of the pattern. I believe she knitted out of worsted weight too, and he did not look this big, but Yeah, he's gonna be pretty big. Last time you saw me, I just had him started. I was still on the yellow, so I only did this, like, what, just in the middle of the night. So I did all the stripes and this part. I'm on the head, I believe. Funny thing is, when you knit at 2 in the morning, I got to like the stripe and I started seeing a big jog. I forgot to do jogless stripes and it drove me crazy. So then at 2 in the morning, I tried to figure out how to drop down and fix it. I somehow managed to do that. I don't know how I did that at 2 in the morning, but now it's jogless. I don't know how at 2 in the morning. I'm impressed that I actually was able to drop down, pick them back up, and fix it all. But yep, he's already a little bit stuffed. I suck at stuffing toys. They're always all loopy. Like he'll have a big bulge here or something. I do fluff up my stuffing and then I put it in, but it gets all compressed. But because I want it firm. Anyways, I'm almost through the face. I don't think I will put the face on. Like, it tells you to put the face on, do the embroidery for the mouth and safety eyes, and then continue. But I'm not doing safety eyes. It's all embroidery, and I'm just gonna wait till I'm done. I look really low. I'm sorry. That's driving me crazy. Hold on a second. Sorry. Don't get sick of me. I should have done that when first time I noticed. Next is the 10 stitch blanket by Frankie Brown, which is a free pattern, and I'm using various Venice Choice and Red Heart Soft random skeins I have in my stash because I have the, oh my god, did I drop a bunch of stitches? No. Sorry, it was like right about to drop, like 3 stitches. I managed to drop none. But it's these various random bits. I think this was Vena's choice. This is, I think, Red Heart Soft. They feel a little different. But this is what I got so far. I'm doing a modification in the pattern. It's not as, like, doesn't stand out as much the pick up where you pick it up, but I'm doing a modification that I got from a verypink.com tutorial. And just started the second color. Was really addicting and then it got boring. So this might be a long time project. But oh, another thing is, it really, you can go and change color in the middle of the row. A verypink, she gives you a tip if you want clean color breaks to just before you do the next mitered corner switch color. And I was playing yarn chicken because that's what I had intended. And I kept weighing it like a crazy person. This is how much I had left of the other because I wanted to use as much as I possibly could, but I wanted to also not have to switch color in the middle or you know. I kind of wanted it to look like a square, not a rectangle, too. So I got close. I think I have 4 grams left. And I think it takes me 2 grams for it's a 9 stitch and a 9 stitch repeat. But the way VeryPink, this is free pattern, so I'm not giving anything away. The way VeryPink tool is set to keep count is every, this is always multiple by 9, the way you pick it up. So every 9 stitch I pick up, I put a little stitch marker. So, and then I have a stitch marker here. So I know it should be 9 ridges, if that makes sense. But I know that those 9 ridges, it takes about, I weighed how many ounces it took me. Or grams. I did in grams. Darn, I have 4 ounces. Did I say 4 ounces? I have 4 grams left. But anyway, so I kept weighing it like after each. And every, it's, I think it takes me 2 grams to do 1 9 stitch. So I would count how many I had in the next row. It was 9, or not 9, but anyway, I did a bunch of math, and I came up that I should have 4 grams left, and I ha ended up with 4 grams left. So that's really good, actually. So yes, that's my whips. The same exact things like last week. I'm trying, like I'm focusing on tiddly wings. I kind of just, I mean, as you could see, I had a decent progress. I'm trying to bang it out. I'm trying. There's some spinning. Not a lot. My back does not like spinning. I could move my wheel downstairs and have it by the couch. The couch is more comfortable for me. Problem is, I have to move my wheel every single time I'm done spinning because of my cats. And I don't really have a place to move it downstairs. Up here, I have my own closet. Once my craft area is set up, I will have a space, but as of now, I don't. So, I had finished Into the World Bodhi. It's this awesome color. I love this braid. I love it so much. It reminds me of my honeymoon, like 100%, because it has these aqua into teal, into darker tealish blue, back into aqua with these pops of this beige that's like the sand. I love it. It completely 100% reminds me of my honeymoon because I went on a cruise and the water and the sand. It looked like this. Sorry, the sand I spin off of. So. And I had finished the first 2 ounces and I'm on the second 2 ounces. And I just grabbed an end and started spinning. It's not very thin. It's very thick and thin because I haven't spun in so long. I kind of just wanted to spin. I didn't want to have to think about it and concentrate about it. And plus, the first 2 ounces I spun so long ago, it's not going to be consistent, and I'm okay with that. So I kind of just went. Down here, some of the beigey in with the teal, and then it got really tealy. Ignore this part. That's my leader yarn. But yes. I'm still spinning that on the Luette. I have not assembled my Ashford. My husband said he was going to start today. He got the power tool from his father yesterday. So he said he was going to try. And it's very complicated putting it together. Especially when we're both not, like, I don't think we ever built anything together. Maybe like the tiny little things, but we're both not handy people. His family, he has 2 brothers and his dad, they're all like mechanics and know how to build stuff, and then he's the odd man out. And then I can build IKEA furniture, which I consider that like a big achievement. Anyway, that's all I have. I have, what did I watch? I watched the series finale of Dexter. I'm not gonna give any spoilers because it just aired yesterday. But I think 90% of the people didn't like it. And I did. So I liked it up to the last 10 seconds. It should have ended, not 10 seconds, it should have ended 30 seconds before, like earlier. If it would have ended 30 seconds earlier, I would have loved it. Because they went on for 30 seconds more, I liked it. I thought it was very fitting. It's very much what me and my husband had predicted was going to happen. Like, very close. A little bit off, but pretty close. They had a twist in there, and we didn't see the twist. Other than that, we were pretty close. It was sad because Dexter is gone. It's done. The show's over. But I thought for what the show is and what they went for, they nailed it. So I thought it was a good finale for the show. Especially because 9 out of 10 series finales suck. Oh, I haven't watched a lot of series finales. Honestly, I remember watching Buffy and I like Buffy, but Buffy was the kind of show, it could have been the cheesiest, the crappiest ending ever, and I would have loved it. I was obsessed with Buffy. Lost was horrible. It should have ended like three seasons before it ended. And that's the only two I can really think of. But anyway, I also watched Breaking Bad. With Dexter, we had an idea. We predicted where it was gonna go. Like, we were pretty close. With Breaking Bad, no clue. My husband started guessing yesterday what he thinks is gonna happen, and I think he's right. But I'm not sure. They're really not. I don't know. I have no idea how that's gonna end. But it's gonna be, that's next week. And then we watched a movie called Now You See Me. Awesome movie. You should watch it. It is about a magician group that becomes like robbers, but they're magicians and they do it in their show and during their show. And it's really good. It's really good. It has twists in it. It's suspenseful. It's very, very good. So I definitely give that two thumbs up, and I think everybody should watch it. I already got two people to watch it from me telling them how awesome it is. The previews did not do it justice because I thought it was going to be bad. It was really good. Really, really good. So that's all I have this week. The holiday knit-along, I forgot to talk about that. It starts October 1st and goes till December 31st. It's any holiday color or any gift you knit for somebody for the holidays or holiday decor. Like, I'm going to knit stockings for me and my husband. I'm going to order you the yarn. I opened a shadow thread, so if you want to go in there and say what you think you're going to be knitting or what yarn or whatever, go ahead. If you have not joined our Ravelry group, we're getting slowly, we're inching up to the 100. Once we get to the 100 milestone, there will be a drawing. And it probably will be a good drawing because I will be so ecstatic once I hit 100 that it will be good. I promise. I promise you guys that. I haven't picked up prices for the holiday knit along. So if you are an indie dyer, bag maker, stitch markers maker, anything, and you want to donate a prize, I more than gladly will take prize donations. If not, I can find stuff. I will buy something or I'll work it out. Anyway, that's all I have this week, so thank you for watching and hope to see you again next week. Bye.
Applause, applause, applause. I live for the applause, applause, live for the applause.